Hello. This short tutorial will explain how to use the Congressional Budget Office's interactive workbook for the distribution of household income report. Links to the report and interactive workbook can be found in the description below. This video will help you learn how to build tables about different components and measures of household income across the income distribution. First, when you open the workbook, you will need to enable content to use the table builder tool. Depending on your version of Excel, you may need to enable editing or make this file a trusted document. You can learn more about the data and definitions of income concepts in the Notes tab. Now, let's make a table that shows income after transfers and taxes across the income quintiles for 2016. First, select the concept. The available options are income, federal taxes, means-tested transfers, and demographics. Let's choose income. Next, choose a category of income measures. You can view summary income measures, components of income, median income measures, or income minimums. To view average income after transfers and taxes, select summary income measures. The summary measure tab allows you to break down different measures of income into market income, income before transfers and taxes, and income after transfers and taxes. Let's select income after transfers and taxes. For this measure, you can either select average amount or shares for income groups. Let's show the average amount. Finally, let's rank households by income before transfers and taxes, which is the default used in the distribution of household income report. For more information about this tab, hover over this note. Now, let's click Build Table to see the results. Now that we have our table, we can see the average amount of income after transfers and taxes for all five income quintiles for 2016. You can toggle this table in several ways. First, you can change the quintiles or income group shown. Click Show All Groups to add a breakdown of the top quintile. Next, you can change household type to households with children, elderly headed households, or non-elderly childless households. Let's change this table to households with children. Finally, you can add years to the table. This would allow us to compare amounts across years using inflation-adjusted dollars. Let's change the start year to show 5 years of data. Once you add more years to the table, you can change the orientation of the table to rank years going down rather than across. If you want to save the table to a new sheet in the workbook, click Save to New Sheet. Now you have your data saved in a new tab. If you want to start a new table, the Reset button will allow you to return to the beginning. This was just one example, but the workbook allows you to create many other tables to explore data from CBO's analysis of the distribution of household income. This concludes the tutorial. If you have any questions about this resource, please send an email to communications@cbo.gov.